So I just reinstalled this motor. It went together fine with this nice little screwdriver and these nice little screws. Would have been nice to have an Allen headed screw, but I don't have any Allen headed screws that small. If I do, I couldn't find them. And it looks like there's plenty of glue on this piece of wood. So I don't know. I probably won't put any more glue on it. So everything's Loctited. All the metal shavings are out of the motor. Nice and quiet. No crunchy sound. So that's good. So I just kind of test fit this FPV setup here. This magnet was falling out of there. So I used some of this. So this went together pretty good. I used that goop just basically because I had it out using it anyways. That's what I used for putting this thing together. I don't know. That's borderline. I don't know if it's strong enough to just have the magnet hold it on there or not. Because if I cut out a hole and put the magnet so it was touching that magnet, I'm sure it would be fine. But just having the magnet go through that piece of plastic, I mean, it's a really strong magnet. So it's pretty good. I don't know if I'd trust it to hold a bunch of my FPV stuff or a camera. And what I'll probably do is just run a rubber band around the whole thing. It's pretty cool though. That way, I can take this off, just run this like that to just fly it. That magnet looks like it's glued in pretty good. Yeah, I think I'd trust that. That's not going anywhere. I can hardly grab the thing off of there. That's good. But as far as this thing goes, I don't know. It's borderline. Oh well, it's still pretty cool. Looks cool too. That's a nice little, it's $30, so for that thing, I don't know if it's worth $30, but it's definitely a nice little pod there, little FPV pod. So I just, on the left wing, the left? Got lucky on this one too, popped right out without too much damage at all. Not bad. I gotta switch this servo arm around, but see how nice those fit right in there? It's like an identical size, so that's nice. These HXT900s, 9-gram servos. Perfect fit. That one wasn't like sketchy where I thought it would come out by itself. That was glued in pretty good, but it popped out without too much foam coming out, so that was good. Okay, so now I got, that's the one I did before. And now I got that one done. I think what I'm going to do is glue these together. I think I'm going to actually stick some glue in here and on that surface so these will never just come apart, because if this gets yanked while this is all glued down and comes apart, I'll have to basically destroy the wing, you know, to get this piece off of there to fix it. Because that, once I glue that down, that's going to be part of that wing. And so is the wire. So I'm actually going to glue these plugs together so they'll never come apart. Same over there. So, yep, keep going. So they're glued together and glued down now. Probably never coming apart. I use servo tape on the servos. And some really good servo tape. I got it. I can't remember where I got it, but this stuff is like the best servo tape I've ever used. That way, at least I can get them out again if I ever want to for any reason. So yeah, they're glued down. I used some goop. So I guess I can glue those plates on there now. So another step that I did was to See, this is, I don't know if it's showing up, but that's real shiny. So I scuffed up the bottom with sandpaper. Nice and shiny on that side. Sandpaper on that side. Because it was really smooth surface, and want to give it every chance it can have to really stick as good as it can. I'm not sure. I could use Gorilla Glue or CA or, you know, Goop or some of that crap that Hobby King gives you in some of their models, just in a white tube. Yeah, this stuff is just a white. It's what I built the Radjet Ultra with this stuff. But it softens this, even the Z Foam EPP type stuff, softens that up even. So I think what I'm going to do is just spread a thin layer of this goop. I'm running out. I need to go get some more. But I think I'm going to spread a thin layer of this all over the place, especially on the corners. And hopefully that'll work. Another thing that I forgot, might as well say exactly what I'm doing here. I also wiped this whole area down with alcohol. Kind of scrubbed it a little bit. And use the dry part to scrub it to get as much of this. All this foam is always covered with release compound, usually. It's like a waxy, kind of gooey substance that helps get it out of the mold, apparently. And glue usually doesn't stick too good to it. So I actually wiped this all down real good, especially on the edges, with alcohol to get as much of that release compound off of there as possible. That's another step that you should probably do if you're doing this. Okay, so this one's glued down. It took quite a bit of glue to spread it all over there with a toothpick. And then I, you know, sat here and kind of clamped it with just with my hands, just kind of putting steady pressure all over it. And then, you know, it looked fine and everything, but then I did one more step. I took a couple big gobs of this goop and ran it all the way around the edges here. All the way around. And right here on this edge. Just to kind of give it a little, this stuff turns into like this rubbery hard, you can, you know, obviously glue your shoes together with it and it'll bond, you know, leather or suede to rubber, and it doesn't really ever come off. I mean, this stuff is, it is amazing how it works. It's nasty though. I got to get a fan in here because I'm breathing the fumes in it. It's no good, you know, it's bad. It's nasty stuff. But yeah, so there's one side done. I still think I might put some carbon right here along this edge. See, this is real, you know, that's real flimsy. This whole thing is pretty flimsy, actually. It's probably good for aerodynamics, but I'm going to tape this over here. These rods only went into about here because I just, and this one won't even, I can't even get this one out. It took a lot of working to get it. That in there, and I only went to here, so I measured, and they're both whatever they are. I put a little piece of tape here as a marker, so I'll get the other one exactly right. It looks like you might even be able to go all the way up here with it, but you just can't. I couldn't. You'd break this whole foam wing, all the structure would be break before you got that in any further. At least mine is real tight. But yeah, so I'm definitely gonna do some more carbon strips like this. I haven't glued this one in yet, but I'm gonna do some more around here. I think they should have used this, another piece like this on this side, maybe. Probably more of this. And without this, it would just be ridiculously flimsy. I might do some more on the trailing edges here, maybe all the way up to this clamp, out to here, trailing edge of the aileron, maybe if I got enough stuff that size. But yeah, this seemed to work pretty good. This goop, it's pretty good stuff. That's kind of a permanent thing though. I mean, that's, I put a little extra length on these servo leads just in case I needed it. Who knows where I'm gonna put the receiver, just in case, so I don't have to add a third extension. Yeah, so that worked. All right, well, I got a fan on that's making some noise, so hopefully that's not too bad. But yeah, I had to, because it was didn't have any windows open and AC blasting. So got the left one done. Just got to put the right one together here. And for the left one, I put the goop on the wing and then stuck the plate on. For this one, I put the goop on the plate and then stuck it on and then went around the edges. And that worked a lot better. A lot easier to spread this glue around on that plate. You know, just sitting in your hand, you can spread it around real good. Get a nice even coat, or fairly even, with a toothpick or something. Popsicle stick, maybe, something like that. And then I just went around all the edges. Around the edges here. Gobbed in a big gob right there. Down this edge. And then down this edge. Put a big gob right in the middle here. But, yep. Worked pretty good. And I'm going to try to put some glue these in. These spars. These strips. Carbon fiber strips. I think I'm going to put one right here. And maybe one angled this way. Like a triangle here. Or maybe two of them like this. And one right here. Just this whole thing could be a stiffer. This whole area. Probably won't be too bad with a spar in there and everything, but this, I don't know, something, a couple of them right there, and then another one right here wouldn't hurt. I think that'll go a long ways into stiffening up these wings without making them heavy. Yeah, they're still really light, so getting there.